I like your cushions.
Thank you. Oh my
Yeah.
goodness. Everyone has been complimenting them. Thank you so much.
I wasn't sure if you were sort of sat in between two poodles or something, but they look great.
I wish. No, they're just pillows.
I watched the film this morning, which is sort of really good fun. It sort of reminded me of the kind of movies I would watch on the kind of Disney Channel when I was sort of growing up. And I was just wondering what it was that initially attracted you to getting involved in this project and to this character.
Yeah, I think the biggest thing that drew me to this story and to my character is the relatability of it all, you know, because we see these characters and they're superheroes and they're princesses and princes, and they're all sort of existing in this very heightened reality. But the core themes to me are very universal, you know, these ideas of empowerment and appreciating yourself and others for what make us different, and using the things you've been given for good. Those are all things that I think we can all connect with and relate to. And, you know, especially teenagers growing up, there are so many pressures to be a certain way, to act a certain way, you know, to get good grades and go to a good college. And, you know, what are you going to do in this world? And I think for these characters, there's the added pressure of having an entire country's eyes on you, you know? And so I think we sort of see them navigate those pressures, which I think, again, are very relatable to anyone growing up.
Yeah, were you personally able to relate in a sense that, you know, obviously having been entwined with kind of like Disney for so long, when you're kind of in public, you're very much representing yourself, you're representing the Disney brand, you've got a big fan base. I mean, in some regards, royals are going through a kind of similar thing on a kind of different scale, but it is the kind of idea of when you leave your house in the morning, it's, you're not just there for yourself, you're there for your fans and people that look to you and look up to you. Like, you've got a big sort of following. I just wondered if you were able to relate on those terms.
Yeah, I mean, I think that's a great point. I definitely feel that. And it's been difficult, you know, growing up, having that added pressure and those eyes on you, and you're sort of trying to figure out how to be yourself and how to be true to you, but also please everyone else. So yeah, I definitely think I could relate to Sam in that sense, and I think sort of my personal experience helped me to get into character and to sort of bring a level of authenticity to Sam's character, because I have those very personal experiences of, you know, oh my gosh, like these little girls, like how am I going to be a good role model to them? And how am I also going to be a teenager at the same time, you know, and sort of finding that balance and the best of both worlds is something I can definitely relate to.
Are you quite sort of encouraged by the success and the freedom of success as well that comes with some former kind of Disney stars or people that sort of did a lot of Disney stuff when they were growing up? If you look at people like Zac Efron and stuff, they're not just making great projects, they're doing really interesting roles that really push themselves as actors. And do you look to them as kind of inspirations and people that have kind of the Disney kind of those who came through the kind of Disney canon?
Yeah, I mean, I think Disney is such a special company. And even though it's such an enormous corporation, it's also very personal to a lot of people, you know, and like, at least I know for me, most of the people I watched on Disney Channel when I was younger, I'm still sort of following their careers and seeing what they're doing now. So there's definitely something very special about the whole Disney canon, and sort of being a part of that is very exciting. So definitely I you know, look up at people like Zendaya and seeing sort of how they've used this foundation at Disney and sort of built upon that. I think it's really inspiring.
It must have been great fun as well to shoot this, because you're kind of, obviously there was a kind of Breakfast Club joke in there as well somewhere, but it was pitting together a group of kind of like-minded people of the same age. Did you guys have a lot of fun when shooting this, and what did you think that in some ways did you kind of fall into the kind of trappings of your own characters? Was there any kind of similarities on set?
Oh, definitely. I think it was actually a very strange experience, because art was imitating life the entire time, because, you know, like you said, we are all very different people in a lot of senses. You know, we come from different places, we have different amounts of experience working, we are all from, you know, different families, and pretty much everything about us was different except for two main things. One, we're all around the same age, and two, we happen to be in the same place at the same time. And just those two core things were enough to sort of get the ball rolling and to get us sort of to start bonding and finding more and more similarities between us. And that same exact thing was happening in the film when they first meet, and they're like, we have nothing in common, but the more they talk and the more they get to know each other, they realize how much they really do, and, you know, how much we all have in common, because of we're all humans, and there is a very universal aspects to life that we all can relate to and connect with. So yeah, I think we were definitely all a lot like our characters, just in the sense of getting to know one another and feeling each other out, and in the end becoming very close.
Well, I'm a believer that most of the best friendships just are built on the fact that we were all in the same place at the same time. Usually that's how friendships start. So that's, yeah. Yeah, I was wondering too, because obviously you've been watching yourself kind of grow up on screen, which must be quite, I mean, I couldn't relate to that, but it must be, for you, I guess it must be sort of kind of normal, but what's it like seeing yourself on screen? Have you quite got used to sitting in your sitting room and kind of put the telly on and there you are? Or is that something that's just become quite second nature to you, or is it still quite surreal?
Definitely not. I don't think that's something that ever just, I mean, at least for me, I don't think that's ever going to be something that's just like, oh yeah, it's like me on the television. Like, it's very strange. It's very weird. I honestly don't like it at all. I don't like watching myself. So I try to limit how much I do that. But I mean, I think it's important, you know, for growing as an actor. But yeah, it's definitely a very strange experience. And like you said, my sort of formative years, you know, most kids have photo albums, and I had 3 seasons of a television show, you know, that sort of documented a big part of my childhood, which is terrifying, but also pretty cool. And I'm really lucky to be able to say that, because very few people can.
Yeah. When you watch that Andy Mack back, do you see yourself on the telly? Is that you see, or is it, because obviously, you know, when I see pictures of myself as a child, I almost don't recognize myself. So I was wondering, when you see yourself younger, do you go, oh, that's me, and remember what it was like to shoot it? It was almost like somebody else.
Yeah, Andy Mack was such a special experience. I don't think it was long enough ago where I don't like recognize myself or remember that stuff. But it's definitely very strange, because it feels like it was all in another lifetime, you know. It's just this other world where that show existed. But I definitely watch back and sort of now I appreciate it more. When it was all coming out, I was like, I really would rather not watch that. But now it's sort of like there are all these memories associated with every single episode. And so getting to watch that show again has been actually pretty fun. I've enjoyed it.
Yeah, I realized the reason I probably don't recognize myself as a child when I look at pictures, because I'm getting really old. That's probably why. So it's just, I'm much further away from it than you are. But anyway, thank you so much for your time today. It's been a pleasure speaking to you. Best of luck with the release.
Ladies and gentlemen, you're watching Hey You Guys.
Hey You Guys, huh?
Hey You Guys.
Is that from The Goonies?
It is indeed, yeah.
Nice.